Okay, hey everybody, this is Josh here with GigaZone Gaming. Just trying out a little bit of the Elder Scrolls Online Tamriel Unlimited today. You know, I held off on even touching this game for a long time. It got really, really a poor reception when it came out. You know, people were complaining about how it really wasn't anything like the Elder Scrolls games. I had heard from a couple of buddies that were in the beta that it was just awful, and I mean, the beta was so bad they didn't think that the gameplay would even stack up, so they didn't want to pursue it at all. You know, that being said, I've been reading some pretty positive things about it lately. You know, a lot of people said, you know, they really turned it around, they really made it what it ought to be. I started it up last night. I got through kind of the initial tutorial type area, and it was interesting. It was fun. It felt Elder Scrolls-y. I was always more of a fan, I think, of Oblivion and Morrowind than I ever was of Skyrim. So I feel like they did a pretty good job of bringing the world Tamriel to life here. This is my character. He's level 5 right now, which doesn't mean much. He's got a few skills, he's done a couple things, but nothing too important. What I was happy to find out was that you can steal in this game, just like you can in the regular Elder Scrolls games. It's kind of part of what makes the world so immersive, is that you can interact with so much. And steal and be a bad guy, or not to be a good guy. I was interested to learn that, you know, when you steal, if you get caught, there's a bounty system, kind of like the regular single-player games. But I haven't been caught, and I don't have a bounty on my head yet, so I don't know what that's all about. But you can see I'm rolling around with some stolen items here. I went with the Breton. And I guess I'm a Templar. I'm not sure exactly how that worked out, but you know, leveling up is somewhat similar to the games. You know, you're really just putting a point in an attribute, magic, health, or stamina, and the rest of it, your skills, is also like the single player game, which I was pretty happy to see. You know, if you use a short sword and a shield, you're gonna get better at using a short sword and a shield. If you use great swords, you'll be better at that. Obviously, some races will start with bonuses to certain types of armor and things like that. The Breton particularly gets a bonus with light armor, so I've been trying to find some of that. That's why I'm wearing these kind of god-awful robes. It's the only real torso light armor I found. As you can see, the world looks good. You know, it's the first-person view that I love from the Elder Scrolls games. You can play third person if you want, but that's nothing new. That doesn't really change from the single player versions of these games. So I arrived here. Apparently I'd been, not to ruin the whole first part of the story, but you end up in kind of another dimension, and when I escaped I got dropped in the ocean. And a captain of a passing ship kind of fished me out. To help her out, I have been kind of trying to get her crew back together. Apparently they mutinied on her. There's been some law changes due to this Dragonfall compact that's been going on here. So pirates aren't supposed to pirate certain ships of certain nations anymore, and her crew was not about that, so they mutinied. And she's kind of stuck here. She
doesn't seem like I'm getting much done here.
Large enough to even sail her ship. But she's got a plan. She had me go around town and get certain members of her crew out of certain tough spots, and then she's going to rob someone here. And hopefully that'll give her what she needs to get back out to sea. So I'll be kind of starting that. We'll kind of see how it goes. Hopefully you'll get kind of a good feeling for the gameplay here, and see if it's something you want to check out. I kind of just picked it up. It was on sale this weekend for $20, so there's no subscription fee that you need to pay. There's an optional one, and I'm not a big fan of paying subscription fees, so I just thought I'd see what I can get. See if I can get my $20 out of it. Yeah, no. So, first I'm gonna make my way to Captain Colleen, and we're gonna get this heist underway here.
Thanks to you, we've actually got a chance to pull this off. Naramo's nice enough for an Altmer if you get past his Dwemer fixation. Thing is, the relics he finds in Dwemer ruins sometimes come in very handy. He just might have a device we can use for our heist. There's a Dwemer ruin outside town, Bithzark. Naramo went there to dig up relics. Help him find some, and he might just join us.
Sure. It's always been one of my favorite parts of the Elder Scrolls games, is those Dwemer ruins. They're always creepy and full of cool loot, so I can go do that before I start this heist off. So, let's see. This way. I was really impressed with the kind of the seaside town that you started in here. It looks pretty cool. Vaguely kind of a mix between Mediterranean and Caribbean feeling, but it's cool. I like it. You can also pickpocket the NPCs if you like, which is always something fun to do. I was kind of impressed by the architecture and these lights. It looks cool. I like it. They did a good job there. So far, the story has been good. It feels really no different than a single-player Elder Scrolls game. I feel like you could play it single-player, and from what I've read, you know, most people say you don't have to really get deep into the multiplayer if you don't want to. It's still a rewarding game in and of itself, just to play it as is.
That old fool won't find me here. Time for whatever it is, I didn't do it.
You seem kind of shady, pal.
Who knows? Naramo, I guess, but not me. I'm only here on Bosek's orders to make sure the elf does his job. I never agreed to dig around in the sand for mad dwarf toys. Be my guest. Go talk to Naramo. I'm sure he'll be delighted to offload more of his task onto some.
So it's cool, you know, it's still kind of got the pick wildflowers for alchemical ingredients and armor making, which I like. These sky shards around, and yes, for every 3 that you find, you get a skill point. There's also these odd little rune things laying around that's kind of how you do the rune building and enchanting of weapons. I still haven't got a chance to play around with that too much. Combat's good. It feels right. It's got a cool kind of blocking mechanic where if your enemy is about to hit you with some kind of big uber spell, then you can do a block and kind of throw them off guard, which is pretty fun.
Miraculous. To think that the Dwemer of Old Volenfell settled as far as Strosmakai. My brother and I have scoured the ruins' exterior for some time now, but we have never been able to get inside. Several reasons. One is that Headman Bosek commissioned me to explore the ruins. A fascinating aspect of Dwemer ruins are the ancient mechanisms to be found inside. Bosek thinks to use them in Port Hunding. I need to get inside to investigate. An excellent suggestion. I believe this automaton can unseal the door, if it can be reassembled and controlled. I have its control rod, but two focusing crystals seem to be missing. Find them, and I'll do the rest.
Sure. Sounds good.
Some call them dwarves, a race of brilliant artisans and metalworkers who possessed great ingenuity. They built vast underground cities filled with remarkable inventions. Now such works are all that remain of the Dwemer. None can say for sure. Some believe they achieved divinity. Others claim they were consumed by some folly of their own. Perhaps both are true. But long ago they vanished, the entire race, leaving little but their marvelous treasures behind. Dim the gleam of avarice I see in your eyes. The treasure I seek is knowledge, worthless to any but a scholar. Those who help me acquire this can expect to be well rewarded, however.
Nice little touch, too, you know, much like the single-player games, there's plenty of books to read. Some of them, I believe, give you some skill updates. I don't know what that lore book and stuff is all about. I don't know, nice little touches like that. It makes you feel like you're actually living in a world here. So let's see if we can't find those. Oh, this is another thing. You get experience for exploring, which I love when games do that. I was playing Guild Wars. It's one of the only things that sounds kind of iffy is they charge quite a bit for their DLC, so that's that Thieves Guild skill line is part of the DLC. That would be fine, I guess. I don't have a huge problem with that, especially in a game that doesn't require a subscription. They got to keep the lights on, they got to keep those servers running, and I understand that. My only real problem with it is that you have to buy their in-game crowns to be able to purchase the DLC. You can do that, or you can just pay a monthly subscription and it all unlocks for you. The problem is, it only unlocks for you as long as you're paying the subscription fee. So I don't know exactly how that works or how that meshes when you feel like you're done paying the subscription fee, but I wouldn't probably. I'd want to just pay for the DLC and be done with it.
Yeah!
rubble down into a horrible mess. Gotta make those potions. Okay, this is one of those rooms I was talking about. They're just kind of sprinkled everywhere. And you can use these, once you figure out what they do, you can use them to enchant your weapons and armor. Earlier when I was playing, I found a corpse on the beach that had a Dwemer gear on him, along with a note saying that someone was paying a lot for Dwemer stuff, so I'm trying to find that as a secondary goal here. Fighting the wolf. I'm after those rawhide straps. I want to kind of figure that out. Get into the crafting. I love crafting, so. That jumping and running never raised your athletic skill at all, but I remember spending a long time in both Morrowind and Oblivion jumping everywhere just so that I could take less fall damage if I fell. Not great for the realism, but it's fun. I like the concept of you getting better at the things that you do. Fence to sell my stolen stuff to, but I guess they're out there. Alright, Naramo, let's open this bad boy up.
I've reassembled a spider, but I must be able to control it. Splendid. Now, I just insert them into the rod like so. Let's see here. It works! I knew it would, of course. Into the tunnel you go. Now to get that door open. At long last, Bizarre! Come, we'll talk of our next move inside.
So yeah, crafting, it looks like you kind of have to find the recipes before you can do real crafting. That's okay, I don't mind that. It'd be nice if there, and I don't know really if there is a way to edge or not, but it'd be cool if there's a way that you could make your own recipes, kind of like the original.
As you see, Headman Bosek's trust in my skills was not misplaced, nor was my faith in your prowess. Will you assist me on another task? Despite the age of these ruins, I suspect the usual defenses are in place. As I am averse to danger, would you explore the ruins to locate any Dwemer generators? This control rod will keep our new friend loyal to you. I suspect the generators have been damaged over the years. You'll need to escort the spider to each and bid it to repair them.
You know, the voice acting's really pretty well done. I don't have any complaints there, that's for sure. What I've heard so far, I've been pretty impressed. Like I said, it feels Elvish.
Thank you.
So, we've come deep into the Dwemer ruins. We're here. We've got the generators running, and now it's time to go find something for Naramo. He says that there are some blueprints in here that he's just dying to get his hands on. So, see if I can't help him out with that. He seems to think that the coin will be worth it, and I'm hoping that afterwards we can get this captain's heist done so she can get out of the port.
Someone took them. I doubt they escaped. These writings could prove crucial to understanding the schematics. My brother should be able to decipher these. Interesting. Continue looking for the schematics. I'll meet up with you shortly.
I'm sure that'll come in handy later on. I don't know how there is pork here, or bread, but hey, not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth. Ooh, star metal, I wonder what that is. Star metal? So yeah, he was saying in his note that this bridge has guardians and that one has traps. So guardians or traps? I guess let's first just kind of try to sneak across and see what we can find. Maybe this is the one with the traps. So far, so good. Those are some pretty obvious traps. I don't think I'll have any trouble missing those. That's okay with me. Take those. Thank you, sir.
There you are. I was just coming to, help you. I hope you found what we were looking for. The schematics are mine at last. Splendid! This place is... I hear Killeen intends to head towards the Isle of Betnik. The ruins there greatly interest me. But first, I will assist you in this heist. Excellent. I must get the schematics to my workshop. Join me if you wish to return to town. Come, Clanker.
Well, that was pretty cool. I like that little mission. Running through those Dwemer ruins was pretty fun. This is that sphere assembly, that collect Dwarven parts that you see up there on the top right. But yeah, let's see what else the captain has to say. Maybe we can get this heist on the road. Let's do this.
We've got a crew to rival the legends. Time to make some money, don't you agree? Now we're ready for the real challenge, the heist. The target's Bosek. That slimy bastard's finally going to get what's coming to him. We're going to steal his sailing logs. His sailing logs are the key to our fortune, friend. They're the records of every ship that's docked here, every stolen cargo they've unloaded, and every illicit payment made to Bosek. Those records are worth a fortune to King Vaharajad. They're written proof that Bosek has violated the king's order to stop raiding Breton shipping. With those papers in hand, the king can threaten to destroy Bosek if he doesn't stop.
Yeah, and are you doing this for pay or out of loyalty? I wonder.
Absolutely. His envoy is on the dock now, waiting. As soon as we turn over the sailing logs, he gives us a fortune in gold. The trick will be getting into Bosek's. First, you need a servant's disguise to get into the palace. The papers are in a lockbox on the top floor. Bosek has the only key. Slip this powder into his drink, then grab the key. The lockbox is always guarded. The guard's not bright, but he'll raise the alarm if anyone tries to open the box.
No stabbing.
Deal with him quietly. No stabbing. Lambert.
Okay. Let's see how stealth missions go.
It's a wonderful day for a sailing trip, isn't it, friend? Especially if it gets me off this rock before Bosek chops off my head. Bosek keeps the key around his neck, cinched steel. I'll get the key off Bosek. Meet me out back.
Cool.
Get your disguise and meet me out back. Leave Bosek.
Quite the motley crew, aren't we? She's right. You need a disguise to get anywhere near Bosek. Fortunately, you have me. My pleasure. Meet me outside the palace.
See, and this is kind of cool because, you know, each of these guys that I saved, I didn't have to do any of this. I could have just went and done it on my own and not saved or helped any of these pirates. But they all are giving me something special to help me on my way.
This is fascinating. Did you know the Dwemer had devices to rapidly... I can offer help with the guard, perhaps. I removed this device from Clanker. When pressed, it produces quite the incapacitating shock. If you would test it, let me know if there are any lingering effects. Twitching.
Awesome. So, I mean, because I did what I did, they pretty much give me everything I need to pull this heist off and not get in trouble while I do it. So, let's go do it. Whoa, what's going on over here? What am I doing? I don't want to get in a fight with the guards. I need to pay more attention when I'm going to help people. Guess he just picked the wrong fight. You know, I'm gonna take a look at my skills before I go in here. I'm kinda curious. Some class skills. It looks like you can kinda go, this is like something of a cleric where you can heal yourself. Can throw some fire. Or you can, I don't know if you summon some kind of magical weapons or what, but I'm gonna go ahead and go with the sunfire. Let's unlock it. Really, like, there's quite a bit of specialization going on, and it's awesome. I'm pretty fond of what I'm seeing so far. Sure, gotta use those skill points on something. Now, on with the heist. There's a sky shard. Looks like I must have already gotten it. It's not glowing and then. Okay. I'm gonna have to cross that bridge, I'm guessing. She said to meet her out front of the palace, so I guess that's where I'm headed.
I have little time to waste.
What do I have left for inventory? I just want to make sure that I've got enough space left to loot. I'm gonna drop some stuff in the bank here before I go in there.
Port Hunding's a place for us.
Some of the stuff I can just sell. Kind of keeping a little bit of this. In case I want to do a different character, maybe one that focuses on heavy armor. It's kind of nice. It looks like they kept a lot of the gold costs kind of low. I like. I've been playing a lot of Black Desert Online lately as well, and in everything in that game costs millions of silver, so it's kind of refreshing to see, you know, usable numbers. That's what the star metal does. Get rid of these. These can go in. Get a belt on.
Sturdy, eye-catching clothes are a must.
Sell some of this stuff that we're not going to use. And it's interesting, you know, your backpack only, you start out only being able to carry 60 things. You can talk to this chick and she'll upgrade your backpack for a cost. The first one was only 400 gold, but the next one's 2 grand. So that's starting to get a little bit pricey for me.
A few coins would suffice.
I would gladly give you some coins if the game would let me. Okay, now for real. Let's get on with the heist.
Greetings.
I'm a guard. Suspicion is my occupation.
Let's see. Crafty, can you help me out here?
Oh, look who's come to pay a visit. Oh, yes. Try these on. I'm sure they'll fit you just right.
Ha ha, her sweep of the palace. Ha ha, ha 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 ha. Well, let's get disguised. And then... the thief told me to meet him out back, and he would have the key for me, so... see if he's around out there.
I'm itching for some action. You look like you've seen some action.
Over there. Oh well, we've got a heist to do. just like an Elder Scrolls game to get you off track with something cool looking over there. Just over the next hill.
His bones. What is it now?
Shouted at you too, did he? He just went out back to carouse with the latest slatterns from the mainland. Best hurry up and refill his drink.
I just wonder where the other guy I was supposed to meet is. I said to meet him out back, but I didn't see him.
Hello.
Ah, there you are, Jakarn. Of course, making time with the ladies.
Ah, my lowly servant. You're just in time. My dear friend, Headman Bosek, is sleeping off the attentions of these two lovely ladies. They are quite a handful, and an eyeful, too. Why don't you take the good headman's key inside for safekeeping?
I'll do just that. Oh, I wonder about that. I didn't see that special item that... the Dwemer device, there we go. Well, hopefully, it's just automated, and I don't have to equip it. Didn't look like it was going to let me, so... oh, I'm just splashing through the fountains. Like a savage. Quite a bit of twitching. You know, don't count your chickens before they hatch, but it looks like that sounds like it was a successful heist to me. We'll see. So far, so good. Let's just get out of here without raising any suspicion. Bounty board.
Hello there.
Chastity belt.
I long to see the far. My friend, welcome back.
And there you are.
Here you are, Tharwob. The shipping logs that show Bosek's defiance of the king's decrees.
The king is pleased with what you've done here, as am I. You will find a generous reward below decks.
It just sounds like a trap. I hope you know what you're doing, Captain.
On your feet, man your stations. Prepare to sail.
Finally, home to Betnik. I've missed my clan.
Before we leave for Betnik, talk to the crew. Get familiar with them. It'll be a long trip.
Okay.
If there's one thing Master Kassan taught me, it's that knowing your ship and crew keeps you alive. Seems like you'd make a fine captain someday, but you'll have to find your own ship.
When active, Dwemer spiders have an extraordinary capacity for learning. Now I have to stop Andrillium from teaching Clanker to bring him drinks.
Strosmakai is a depressing place. Too many Red Guards waving their damn swords around. At least on the spearhead, no one wants to kill me except Irian. She'll come around. She's crazy about me.
You rogue.
Wonderful. Now I've been ordered to follow Naramo.
Before we leave for Betnik, talk to the crew. Then we leave for Betnik, an orc island that hasn't yet joined the Covenant. I hope to change that. Lembor's happy to go home. She may try to thank you with ale.
And we're off. So yeah, you know, I hope this kind of gave you a little bit of the flavor of the Elder Scrolls Online. You know, maybe it's something that you could see yourself playing. I don't know. I think it's fun. I think a lot of the hate that this game garnered when it came out might have been deserved then. But from what I've played so far, it's a good game. I'm really liking it. It's pretty cool. It does feel a little bit Elder Scrolls light, but a lot of the elements are here, and you know, I guess it's no lighter than Skyrim was, so yeah, give it a shot. Hope you enjoyed watching, and once again, for GigaZone Gaming, this is Josh. I just want to throw a little plug in there. We've got our League of Legends Gaming Championship coming November 12th. Sign-ups for that, we're taking individual sign-ups as well as team sign-ups. They'll need to be in by September 16th. Of 2016. It should be a good time. You know, there's $4,500 worth of cash or prizes on the line. We're giving away an Oculus Rift just to one lucky attendee there, so come on down. It should be fun. So yeah,